out here on a day when there is big, big thunderheads or whatever you'd want to call them off in the distance out there. You can see the sky. Look at those. But it's clear where we're at here to the east, I mean to the west. This is where we are out there at the North Jetty. There's all the traffic of everybody and their brother heading offshore. Everything to do about this time of year is, oh, kingfish, kingfish, kingfish. And then comes winter, and it's sheephead, sheephead, sheephead. Well, everybody else is concentrating on that. I have my own personal challenges to go. So, it's raining right out there right now. There's three shrimp boats and two ships sitting out there. And it is pouring rain, but that could be 15 miles away for all we know. We're at the Mayport Jetties. We're going to try and catch about a dozen perfect-sized croakers. This is take them up in the St. John's River and try to target big gator speckled sea trout. And the croakers have been pretty thick out here once the tide gets falling. All we got here is a bag of fresh frozen shrimp. These are all shrimp that used to be alive in my live well. And all we're going to do is just take a shrimp. You can kind of get rid of his head. Pinch his tail. All you want is a little piece. And as these shrimp get bit, pretty much the croakers come as they get the scent. Everything else comes. This time of year at the inlet here, there's just fish everywhere. And all Aaron's going to do is he's going to take this and he's going to drop it to the bottom, and I'm going to go along with him. And we're going to see if we can catch some croakers. I have my live well filled up full of fresh ocean water. And got it aerated. As Aaron's going to try catching the first croakers, they're all over the place out here, especially on the fallen tide. I'll show you my setup. I've got another video completely about this. There's my oxygen tank and regulator. Then I've got an IcyTech split cooler here. And there's the water with my ceramic air stone, diffuser stone. Put some nice clean ocean water in here. And when we start catching croakers, I turn on the oxygen bottle over here. Turn on the oxygen bottle and I feed them pure oxygen. And at the same time, the oxygen coming out of the tank's like 55. Plus I got this side. What I normally put shrimp over on, this side, but over here I'm gonna give the croakers a little better swimming room than in this small space. And what that does is it keeps our croakers good and small, getting good and aerated. And Aaron's already got something on. Let's see what it is. And it is a beautiful little croaker. So, let me, that's how you croaker fish. Somebody asked, when we gonna have a video about catching croakers? The only problem is his butt got blown out because we just pulled him up from 45 feet of water. All right, so let's unhook him real easy and real nice. Unhook him. He done swallowed it, so there's a damn good chance now that this one might not work. We're gonna get rid of this one since he swallowed it. We don't want him swallowing the hooks. That would be a medium. Hold them up right here so we can see them. That would be a medium. Look at that. It's a perfect bait. So there's two for the live well already. There we go.
And let's see if we can see the foaming. See the foaming of that oxygen? Look at that. It is foaming. And we got our croakies swimming around in there. They'll be happy, happy, happy.
It's a croaky kind of day. That's the perfect little croaker for a tree shake a gator trout.
All right, we're on the first spot. I'm using a 2-aught Kale croaker hook. What I always end up doing here is we're fishing in good current, so I'm going to hook him through his nostril. There he is. I got a 30-pound leader about this long, as you can see. Go to my strong arm, and the current's strong enough right now. We need about a 4-ounce sinker. This isn't the Gulf of Mexico. I wish it was. And I'm just going to put that croaker right behind the boat, and I'll show you how the rods are bending. These rods are really light. Click the reel over, a nice light drag. We're gonna be pole holder fishing here, watching the rod tips. Pretty much what makes this trout fishing versus, like, I do the same thing for redfish. If I was going after bull reds using the croakers. But you can see the rod tip. And you can see the rod tip over here, how it's bending. And look what I actually did. This was just a joke. I put a label on here that says live croaker rod. Thing over here, live croaker rod, but they're the ugly stick stripers. So we're set up right now. We got two of them behind the boat, and it's just a patience game now. So if we get something, I'll turn the camera back on and see what the story is. Of a good day, I think. We got a little bit of a northwest breeze coming from that direction. We're sitting on a falling tide where there's rocks underwater, where I've caught 7-pounders before. 2 7-pounders came from this exact spot with lots and lots and lots of other trout. I mean, lots of other trout. Big bull reds we've caught here up to like 28 pounds. Just had one here the other day, just absolutely sizzle a guy, a young kid on a boat, break him off. So that's pretty much it. Always a long structure. Remember, H-A-R-D means F-I-S-H. It's all just a fishing game. I'm nowhere near where I caught him in the other video that I did. That was way downriver. Way upriver, however you want to look at it. But we're going to try it here, and then we're going to move off to another spot. All right, we just had a major, major knockdown here on this croaker. On this size croaker, I don't know. The hook's a little screwed up. Maybe we'll put out a fresh croaker now. I mean, he's still alive, but that rod went whoop, and just kept going, didn't it?
Yeah, it sure did.
All right, we're going to go to a micro croaker now. There's a micro croaker. Ooh, see, that's what we want them to do when they're down on the bottom. I want them to croak when he's under duress. Oh, yeah. Him right through his nostrils. Somebody definitely pulled that thing down.
Give it a couple more seconds next time, maybe?
Yeah, I guess we're just
Or is it just hit or miss when it comes in?
Well, we're just going to have to let them really... Yeah, just let them play on it a lot more next time.
Okay.
It's hard to determine because these rods are so... These rods are so bendy that, you know, he's doubling the whole rod completely over, and you're like, when do you pick it up, you know?
Yeah. Definitely don't want to yank it out of its mouth.
But you're hoping he's going to take the whole thing down. That was definitely a bite. See, the whole thing about this is you're going to catch nothing but maybe the fish you're looking for. Of course, you can get a bull red, big giant flounder, a trout. Of course, jack crevalles are going to hit them. It's probably no secret where we're sitting right now, but it's another HARD, means F-I-S-H. We already fished two spots, just one spot, and then we moved forward on it and fished a little more sand next to some rocks. So now we're giving it a shot here, and if nothing happens here, then we're going to boogaloo and keep hitting it. I tested the salinity of the water at the last spot. I guessed it perfect. 15, 18 parts per thousand. And it was exactly 18 parts per thousand. There we go. Right here while we got them on. Right here while we're filming. Nice and easy. He's smoking it, folks. I'm going to pull this one in. Keep your rod tip up. We don't know what it is. Don't let him go towards those rocks.
He's coming right in.
Okay, let me get the net. Right while we're filming, folks. There he goes. Okay, hold your rod tip down. Giant trout. Woo! It's a giant trout, folks. It's a giant freaking trout. Woo! That's what we're looking for. That's what we do when you catch a big... When you catch croakers, what do? You sit here in the middle of the summer and you catch them like that.
Holy shit.
Come back here, Aaron. Come back. This is the man of the hour right here. The man of the hour. Okay. That's all the proof I ever need to show you folks. This is the bait from hell and back. What did I say in the other video? Get you some croakers. Now look at that hook. It is completely around the bottom jaw. 2-watt croaker hook, which is commonly referred to as a kale. All right. That.
Look at his mouth.
That's what makes the world go round, folks. That's what makes the world go round. Look at the size of that son of a bitch right there. He can be a lot bigger, but he's not. You're not going to catch 14, 15 inches, and you're not sitting here getting one bait stealer after another. Okay? It's going to be the fish you want, and that's the only fish you're going to catch. All right, man, what do you think?
I think we should measure.
We just did it. We did it. Okay, let's measure him up. Now we catch these float rig fishing, but right now, if you're using shrimp on a float rig, what's happening? You're getting bait stealered to death. All right, put them on the official gator board, baby. Okay, put them right on the bottom jaw. And he is a little bit, there you go. He is just short, let's see, just short of 24 inches. That is not anything to sneeze at right there, folks. That is nothing to sneeze at in the middle of the summer at 11 o'clock in the morning on a Sunday morning. All right, brother, hold him up again. That's what we come out here for. Put him in there with Mr. Whiting, like he's gonna fit. Let's do that again. Of course you could do this with mullet. Of course you could do it with pogies. But we had a good time. Did we have that? We had fun catching croakers.
Yeah.
I never have fun when I'm catching pogies because I'm throwing a goddamn net, getting all slimed up, and what a half of them do, they die. I mean, I don't carry a recirculating live well on the boat anymore because I don't want one. I got an oxygen bath. All right, we're gonna try it again. All right, we just had another one on. The croaker was way behind the boat, and I was tightening up on him, and he was right here. The fish was up under the boat, swimming around with the croaker in his mouth, and now he just come off. Let's rebait him. We had another one on. That's three bites within 30 minutes. Look at this trout. Just like the first video. If you watch the first video, which will be a link in the video description, if you missed it, the first video of me several years ago doing this, we just caught this one right here, and here's what happened. And then we just went, oh, we lost them. But if you look down there,
there's the fish.
There's the croaker's tail in its mouth. I'm sure you can't see it. The hook is down its throat. There's the croaker. I can feel the croaker. Just like in that first video, my first trout ever on a live croaker was 19 inches. What's this? 19 inches? I can hear the croaker.
You can hear the croaker.
You can hear the croaker. He's still alive. Look at this, watch. Look, watch your stomach. Look right there, watch. Can you see that? I am yanking the croaker backwards in his stomach. I'm gonna have to cut it.
Yeah, there's no.
I'm gonna have to cut it. There's the croaker right there, folks. I'm knocking the croaker on top of the head right now. That is truly, truly amazing. Oh, I ain't getting that out. We'll get that out when we clean them, and we'll show you.
So we got the gator and we got the sweetheart.
Yes. And he fooled us. He fooled us. Now we're going to put him up front. My little small spot on this cooler here isn't big enough. What do you think about that, brother?
I can't believe it. I thought we were reeling in the croaker, man. Because he didn't fight at all.
I actually, you know why he didn't fight? Number one, he's gut hooked. Number two, he just ate a croaker. He's like me after eating a bunch of hamburgers.
He's digesting it.
Oh, my God.
That's good, man. That's great.
Excellent.
How about that shit?
What we're doing, folks, is we are fishing and struggling at this point to find the perfect current. The perfect current for doing this, obviously, is the perfect current for catching trout. Same as if I was float rig fishing. Just a walking current, nothing raging. The first spot we fished was a 4-ounce spot, and that was a little raging, and it felt like it, didn't it?
Yes.
So. All right, let's see. We've had 1, 2, 3. That's 4 bites, but only 2 fish. They will freak you out a little bit sometimes. They go, and they just ain't there. Okay, folks, we got one on. We don't even know what it is. It's big. Is it taking drag?
Yes.
Okay, this might be a red. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
This is a trout at the 30-incher.
We got it. Oh, yeah. It's a big giant redfish or a stingray or something big. Oh, there he is. Don't even turn the handle. He's smoking it off. That's the one I just have the lightest leader on. I just put the lightest leader on that one. LT at its finest. Light tackle, baby. Light tackle. Oh, my God. My biggest redfish on a lure came from this spot.
Now remember, as you pull back, you try to pull back without the drag breaking free. Okay. Then you're just fighting a tackle. Well, we might have to come back to this when it is more of a conclusion state. This will be a while.
All that line, I just got back.
Yep. I was just about... Oh, he just came off. Finally. Finally. I hate to say what I think that was. Oh, my God. But why would a stinger be up in 6 feet of water? We're in six and a half foot of water around rocks. Why would a monster stinger be up here? He's still on.
Did he just get tired all of a sudden?
Yeah, and he just swam towards the boat. We got him on. We thought we just lost him.
It felt like the line snapped.
I know. Okay, folks, look at the size of this bull red. Keep swinging him out. Swing him out. Oh my God. On the lightest tackle we got on the boat, folks. The lightest tackle. Look at this. This is what you also catch when you fish live croakers in 6 feet of water. Look at the hook just fell out of them. The hook just fell out. Look at that, folks. Whoa. And here's what he caught him on. A Daiwa Ryoga. And look at that hook. It's not even bent. It's not even bent. There's the hook. Same thing we're catching trout on.
I can't even hold him the way that you're supposed to hold him because he's so heavy.
Oh my God. Let me get a picture. Here's my release pole. Many of my subscribers have been wanting to know about this. It really works. Okay, drop them down a little bit. Hook them. Okay, go ahead and take that one off. Ugh. That's why the release pole's nice, folks, right there.
Get them breathing or, in the water again.
Get them in the water. And I don't have to lean over. No leaning over. Wow. Yep. Right over there produces some big bull reds, man. Ain't that something? I might have to blow the air out of his gut here.
How do you do that?
With the release needle. So, yeah, put your hand in there just in case. Okay, let's hike him up. Let's lay him right up in here.
Hear the air?
Yep.
Now I can
literally hear the air coming out of him.
I got fish shit on my shit.
Yeah.
Green fish shit.
All right. Let's get him back in the water.
Belly, he needs to sit up. There, see now he's sitting up?
Yep.
This pole, gripper pole, is so handy because the side of my boat here is so tall, which is one of the things I love about this boat. But at the same time, I'd have to be hiking over the side without this pole. I got this on my Amazon Tools of the Trade product page. And the reason being is because as soon as I found this thing, I was like, this is all about bull red drum releasing. You can dip them down. get them down there in the water. He's still floating a little bit. Go.
Still floating, so that's good, right?
Yeah, I know, but... Well, hopefully he's okay. See, it's all about this. It's just like a boga grip. 44-inch pole, I believe it is. So you know if you got a redfish that's big, this big, it's Big Daddy. Aaron said earlier, what'd you say? Something about, you know, I think before the day's end, we're probably going to have a redfish. But we were thinking smaller. That is a light tackle battle from hell and back right there. This ugly stick, look at this. That is not made for catching bull reds. It's my croaker trout fishing rod. And totally unscathed late leader. Congratulations. This one went for the croaker in his stomach. There it is, right there. Mm-hmm. That is one fresh croaker. There he is. He was still croaking, and we could hear him inside the stomach. Here's my leader. We can catch this sumbitch without a hook. There you go. That's not too bad. Put the hook still in the croaker's nose. Man, that was one hungry trout. There you go. When they're hungry, they're gonna eat anything.
Thank you.